You know what? It's a good thing that you're so good at your job of broadcasting and you were such a great hockey player, because I don't know about your singing career, bud. I don't know.
Yeah, well, you'd be surprised, Jamie. America's Got Talent called me this morning. So. No, wait. Hold on. Let me clarify that. This American's got no singing talent.
Yeah, that's what I thought. That's another show.
Yes.
That's another show.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, hey, what a fun day at the ballpark for you. Yeah. And we have more video, folks, because Eddie also threw out the first pitch at Wrigley Field. Now, this is impressive.
This was nice.
Yeah, this was really nice. We're watching it here. Take us through. Are you nervous here?
Oh, yeah, just don't bounce it in there. Mike Montgomery, the Cubs pitcher, is right there. And I threw a little cutter there. I went with the seams, EJ. I went with the seams. And that thing dropped a little bit.
Yeah.
And it was great that Mike Montgomery was there to catch the ball, and it was a great thrill. But, yeah, I was more nervous about throwing that pitch, because if you bounce it in there or airmail it there, man, I'm never going to live that down.
Yeah.
So I had to bring my best stuff. So, yeah, I made it all the way. The radar gun is still intact. I probably got to about maybe 68 Canadian, so probably about 40 U.S. So we had a good time, and the Cubs, and obviously through the Blackhawks, but the Cubs did a great job, and appreciate them having me and my family out there last night. It was a great thrill. It was my fifth time that I sang, believe it or not, at Wrigley, and it was a real big thrill to be out there, and they gave me a nice Cub jersey. So wish they would have won the game last night, but better day today. They won a game today against the D-backs finally.
What does summer look for you right now? What does summer look like for you right now? You're home, right?
Yeah, I'm at home and just kind of taking it easy, Jamie. You know, the last year has just kind of been, it's kind of been a blur, really, you know, coming off the stage 3 colon cancer battle that I've had. And it's really hard to believe that it's been a year already since I was diagnosed with it. And, you know, just kind of living day to day and coming off the great playoffs that we had. I mean, what a Stanley Cup final that we had between, you know, Vegas and Washington, and, I'm just kind of catching up with my family and just kind of taking it day to day, and my oldest son, Eddie, is getting married in 9 days here in Chicago, so that's kind of keeping us busy, and things are much better now than they were a year ago right now, and I feel very, very lucky with where I am in my life, and looking forward to seeing teams at training camp and seeing what goes on come hockey season in a couple of months from now.
Well, you look great, and we are thrilled that everything, as you've kind of come out on the other end of this, you've been a great inspiration for all of us. You know we love you here, and so
Thanks,
CJ. Keep up the good work, baby. You look good. You're throwing that fastball. You're singing. You're doing everything. I want to ask you, we got to ask you, we had the big story of the day is Jerome Iginla is officially announcing his retirement. He did not play last year, but was still thinking about maybe coming back and trying to give it a go. He decides to retire. For you, Eddie O, what do you think about when you think about Jerome Iginla?
Well, I mean, I think he's the type of guy, EJ, that I would want any young player my organization try to emulate, right? Like, because he carried himself with great dignity, with great pride, competed. He went about his business, and, one of the premier power forwards. I heard you and Jamie touching on a little bit earlier. I mean, he's just one of those guys that you knew exactly what you were going to get, and he had that ability to go ahead and say, you know what, I'm going to change this game by dropping my gloves. I mean, he was a tough, tough player, and nothing but great respect for him, and very happy for him and his family that he's be able to go out on his terms, so to speak, and retire as a member of the Calgary Flames. But I think any organization would want that guy to be kind of the poster man of their organization, just the way that he carried himself off the ice, the things he did in the community. I know he was very popular in the things that he did in the province of Alberta and also in the city of Calgary. And a lot of those, EJ, we know, there weren't cameras around, there weren't media around. Like, Jerome Iginla's the type of guy to do things because it's the right thing to do. And as a former National Hockey League player, and talking about Jerome Iginla, is that, you know, we're supposed to do those things. You don't need it for the limelight. You do it because that's part of your job. And I wish him the very best in his retirement. And but he was an all-around player without a doubt. And you knew when he was on the ice, regardless if he was playing his fifth game in the NHL or over 1,000th game.
All right, Eddie, one more retirement for you today. Justified. Triple crown winner. Already hanging him up. Eddie, give us your thoughts. Yeah. This horse won us a few dollars.
Yeah, he did, EJ. So I think you might have used that money to buy that new suit there. That thing's looking nicer tonight. So, look, I think it's always, you always like to see these horses run is you know, late in their three-year-old campaign and into their four-year-old campaign. But just like the National Hockey League, horse racing is a big business. And for him to, you know, to go to the breeding shed, my quick math probably tells us it's probably worth $40 to $50 million a year. So if he can do that for the next 8 or 9 years, EJ, he's going to be up in your stratosphere of salary, because
that's true.
It's pretty pretty serious stuff. So, you know, it's sad, but we understand, you know, I understand the horse racing business as well as anybody. And actually, I talked to Bob Baffert, the trainer for Justify, on Monday, and, you know, he just said he and I had an idea that this was going to happen this week. And Bob told me that, you know, the 112 days, the six races he ran in 112 days being undefeated just kind of caught up with him, and he couldn't get him right. And, you know, this is the right thing. And you always want to do right by the horse and the animal. And that's what Justify's owners and Bob Baffert have done. So, yeah, sad day, but hopefully we'll have another Triple Crown winner. And, oh, by the way, EJ, you know this, Jamie. Since my part, a very small part on NBC's horse racing coverage for the Triple Crown, I've been there 4 years, and we've had two Triple Crown winners. Yeah. So maybe it's time
maybe
to get
it's
in.
You.
Yeah, maybe it's the. Oh, well, yeah, I'd like to think so. Maybe I can use that when contract negotiations come up here in the next little while. So yeah, it's been great to be a part of this for sure.
Who knew you can tune in to NHL Network to hear all about horse racing?
That's right.
Justify's retirement. We love having Eddie O on the show for just that, and also to talk a little bit about Blackhawks before we let you go. Corey Crawford. The biggest question about this team right now is what his health status is. What can you tell us?
Yeah, well, I think it probably, if you had me on next week, it'd probably be give you a better answer, Jamie. But the Blackhawks have their annual convention, the 11th annual Blackhawks convention, coming up this weekend, and Corey Crawford is going to be there. And look, he has not seen the ice a lot since December 23rd of last year when he got pulled in a game in New Jersey at the Rock. And you know, Stan Bowman addressed the media, the general manager of the Blackhawks, a couple of weeks ago, and he said he saw Corey. He said he looks good. But again, I mean, I think the questions are valid. Has he been on the ice? Has he seen any pucks lately? You know, how is he feeling? So, you know, maybe Corey Crawford will address that this weekend. But, it is a big ask, you know, as far as Corey Crawford is concerned, to know where he is and to see, look, if this team is going to get back to where they were 2 years ago, Corey Crawford's going to have to be 110%. And get back to where he was. But until he answers that, I think the questions are valid. So hopefully we'll have a little bit more clarity here this coming weekend at the Blackhawks convention.
Yeah, we certainly root for the health of all the players. So hope for good things for him. Eddie, thank you so much for joining us. Always great to catch up with you.
Okay, EJ. See you, Jamie. Thanks.